Hey, photo world, welcome back to another episode here on takeandtalkpics.com. This is another episode from the former podcast. Please subscribe, hit that notification bell, and join the email list. Let's get to that 1,000 subscriber marker so that way I can add a new video every single week. Enjoy. Hey, photo world, this is Take and Talk Pics, episode 6. I'm your host, Rob Kruger. Before we get started today, I wanted to thank you for this amazing launch week. Already, we've had a little over 450 downloads for Take and Talk Pics just this week. Take and Talk Pics has been reaching all across the United States, the United Kingdom, France, Hungary, Canada, Singapore, the Philippines, Switzerland. It's becoming a global scale of listeners, and I know that there's a photo community out there, so I really applaud all of you for being a part of it and joining me on this journey. I cannot thank you enough for your support, for your listening, for your attending each day here and coming to the new episodes and learning more about these photographers. We have another great one today. And then next week, just a reminder, we kick it off with our 3 days a week schedule. Launch week was a big one, and we wanted to give you a lot of information. We wanted to give you a lot of variety on how Take and Talk Pics is going to be playing out as a taste for what the 3 day a week show will be. There's a few really great things in the works here. The website is getting its final touches, a little bit more of the excitement here. I'm scheduling a workshop. Be ready for that announcement coming up next week of when and where the workshop will be taking place. Yes, we've had our first winner this week for that iTunes gift card. Be sure to head over to takeandtalkpics.com and sign up for your chance to win. It's as easy as clicking that side button there to subscribe and get your chance to win an iTunes gift card, and you will be in the weekly drawings. So stay tuned for that, because every Wednesday I'm giving away an iTunes gift card. And enough of me talking, let's get on to today's show and get you another amazing photographer. Again, episode 6, the final day of launch week. Thank you, thank you, thank you, photo world, and happy shooting. Here we go.
Okay, he's like anybody who knows who this man is. He's just an extreme amount of help to the photography community.
Today's featured guest is Sherry Hagerman. Sherry's company, Allusion Photography, specializes in weddings, engagements, boudoir, and cinematography. Sherry has recognized that as a bride and groom's journey begins, the pictures are becoming their first family heirloom. Allusion Photography has mastered this important task and captures moments that will be everlasting memories. Sherry, welcome to Take and Talk Pics. I've shared a brief overview about you and your business. Please take a minute to share with Photo World a little bit more.
Hey, Rob. Thanks for having me. Well, you basically introduced me. My name is Sherry. I'm the owner of Allusion Photography. We're located in Hinsdale, Illinois. Currently voted one of the best wedding photography studios in the United States. And we have a staff of about 24 photographers and graphic artists.
Wow. I mean, building a large company like that, it appears like a small boutique studio when you look at your website. So you know it's a tight-knit group, just really clean delivery of your imagery, looking like the perspective of one photographer. So it means you guys come together really nicely.
Thank you. We are, you know, an extreme boutique. We do a lot of our own products. We make our own albums by hand, and everything that we offer is done in-house. So it's a great company to work for.
That's wonderful. Sherry, I love stories, and I really appreciate you doing the interview and bringing us right there with you along your journey. And to get us started, is there something, some sort of inspiration, a quote or mantra that you run your business by or you live by on a daily basis to get that inspiration flowing?
Absolutely. So the quote that I really, really like and value a lot is, a creative man is motivated by the desire to achieve, not by the desire to beat others. And basically what that means is, we're not out here to compete with each other. We're here to learn from each other and work with each other. To give you an example of that, in the Chicagoland area alone, there are over 60,000 weddings a year. This has been a number that's been established for over 4 years now. And with that, not even one person can do 1% of those weddings alone. So it just shows that we shouldn't be competing with each other. We should be working together to make it a better industry.
awesome. Really just a nice peace of mind for photo world out there, that there's no reason to look at it as competition, but to look at it as, way you kind of broke it down, is it's networking. Get to know one another, help each other out, and then lift each other up to go get your piece of it. It's not really just a piece of the pie in total. It's kind of abundance. I mean, there's so much available that we should all be able to go get what we value our work at, what our customers will value our work at, and we'll all do fine together. So I really love that as a great start off here.
Definitely work with each other.
Sherry, could you share with Photo World a time where you had learned the hard way? A failure moment, maybe just something that didn't go so right, but you learned a ton from it.
Well, in my first year of business, I didn't know a whole lot about the business, didn't know what I was doing, kind of just threw myself right into the line of fire. And I had everyone's worst fear, shot a wedding, and I did not download all of the cards, as well as the hard drive crashed on me. It was a nice double doozy going on there. Ooh. But yeah. So I actually felt responsible to try to recover everything that I had lost. I sent the drive off to a clean lab. They charged me $7,000 to check over the drive and came up with nothing. It was definitely broken. I gave the client themselves their money back. I only lost the reception part of the wedding, but I felt horrible about it. As a photographer, we're saying that we're a professional enough to make sure that you get all of the images. I didn't do that. So I did swallow my pride. I contacted their guests. I got images that other guests had taken and graphically enhanced them to make them look as professional as I could, even though there's pretty much no way you can do that. And I at least gave them something on disc that they could remember their day by, but it was just a horrible, horrible, fearful experience. But I learned from it. Now we back up our images on three different drives. We back them up on the cloud, and we have a system in place for downloading cards. There's never, ever anything to be missed.
Yeah, that's definitely a rough one to learn by. I mean, we all have our times when we need to learn the hard way, and I've had, you know, no shortage of them. There's failure moments all over the place. Man, that's a big one and a stressful one that could really take people, maybe Photo World, you could be devastated by that experience if that were to happen to you, and maybe it would be enough to say, no thanks, this isn't for me, I can't do it. But Sherry, you pushed past, you kept going, and here we are 11 years later, and you got an awesome business going, and yeah, the systems are in place, so... great value there. You know, Photo World, see it as an opportunity to improve.
Definitely.
Not a failure.
Back up your images twice.
There you go.
More than once.
Yeah. The worst thing that would happen is you have too many backups, but that's not a bad thing. You know, space is cheap, so do it.
Right.
Sherry, what would you consider the most important practice of your photography? Is there a piece in the workflow that ends up being something that's implemented into each job?
Absolutely. I think it's getting it right out of camera. I'm not a big person on editing, and a lot of people would call BS on it, but what you see on my website, things like that, there's very minimal editing on my images themselves. If I have to spend over 1 minute editing an image, I'm not a happy camper. So getting it right straight out of camera, knowing how to use lighting techniques, knowing what aperture should be, your ISOs, your exposure, your white balance, know how to do it all. And the way to do that is your manuals. Your equipment all comes with its own manual. Read it. Make it your Bible. I've been told that once, and ever since I've been told that, it made sense. Mm. That photography manual is your Bible. Use it and figure out how to make it work for you. Learn your equipment.
Absolutely. I teach at College of DuPage in Glen Ellen. I tell my students all the time, you know, we'll get there. We'll learn how to do this. People start just jumping out. Oh, how do we do this? How do we do that? How do we use flash? How do I, you know, when do I know how to use the ISO this way or that way? Learn the equipment you have, because all the equipment is very different. There's a wide range out there. Learn your equipment, learn you. And the way I break it down is educate yourself, and then you can educate your images based on your knowledge behind the camera rather than, you know, the equipment you're using. So learn what you have, because it'll surprise you. I recall a time when I had it was a Nikon D300, and I was just getting burnt out on that camera. Everybody is getting these great, awesome new cameras, and I'm like, it's time to buy. I know it is. And I'm using it and using it. And finally, I realized, you know what? I'm going to bring another light to the situation. So I brought a studio light with me to wedding receptions rather than just two speed lights. And I put it up in the corner and then had my mobile speed light with my assistant. And just adding that much more light to the room, it didn't matter about the ISO anymore. I wasn't worried about it. It was just realizing that, hey, there's other inexpensive ways to go about beefing up the use of this camera. And, you know, if I would have just guessed at that, I don't think it would have worked. It was educating myself and finding out, or realizing, the light is the image, you know? So bring that in first, then you can upgrade to this camera or that lens or whatever.
It's funny that you say that, Rob, because not a lot of people understand that. There are a lot of natural light shooters out there. I commend them.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, that light's going to go away at some point in the day. If you don't have light, you don't have an image.
Right.
So really, you can have the nicest equipment in the world, but if you're not properly using the light, I call it quality of light, you're not going to have that great of an image at one point.
Quality of light, photo world. Light is your world here. I love it. Like, that's beautiful. We have a wide range of photographers listening, and could you share with Photo World something that may help to lead to growth and success in their business, something that you might have found kind of gets you in that direction?
I would say it's education, and I'm not talking about the education that you get in college or things like that, your schooling. I'm talking about ongoing education, seminars, learning from other people. Seminars, I think, are a very, very important part of this industry. I try myself to attend at least 2 to 3 seminars a year. You know, for example, I'm taking 6 of my employees to WPPI this year to help them understand how important that ongoing education is in their learning experience. At these seminars, you're going to learn from some of the best photographers that have been through situations that are going to incur with you. They're going to teach you about equipment. They're going to teach you about lighting, but they're also going to teach you how to run your business. A lot of photographers just kind of get out there, take the photos and wait for the business to walk to them. And without learning, you really don't have anything to fall back on. I almost, Rob, say that it's important to adapt. You have to follow the trends. And if you can't adapt, your business is going to flatline. The way of adapting and learning new trends is through these other seminars and learning from other people, networking.
See what's out there, because the environment changes constantly and you have to be ready for those changes. Photo World, don't know if we said this earlier, but Sherry is not only bringing her employees and team out to learn for WPPI, she is actually going to be teaching at WPPI this year, and that is an amazing thing to learn about you, and I hope it's a true honor for you. It sounds beautiful to get an opportunity like that, and just with the interview we have here, Photo World, listen up, because you're having this amazing access to Sherry's knowledge and information. If you got time, get out to WPPI next time and see everybody, and Sherry will be there too. So awesome.
It's going to be a fun time. It's definitely one of the better seminars that I do enjoy. But there's other seminars out there, you know, such as Skip Summer School, there's Shutter Fest that's going on this year. There's a lot of great photographers out there that are providing great seminars and classes for other people. Just check them out. They're not that expensive, and they're going to have a lot of fun. You're going to meet a lot of new people.
Invest in yourself so you can invest in your business.
Yes, that's exactly it.
Sherry, has there been a time when you had an aha moment? It kind of hit you either early on in your career, or maybe it was in the past couple of years. It was right there, you know, this is it. I need to do this next.
Probably year two in the business. By year two, the floodgates kind of just opened, and I realized that people liked my work. I necessarily wasn't doing everything right at that point. I was only in year two of my business, so I didn't know everything. I don't even know everything now, but at then, I definitely did not know a lot of what I was doing. The important part was people liked my work, so I must have been doing something right. That's when I realized I had dropped everything I was doing, and this was going to be it. This was my life.
And to that end, moving forward through the career, has there been a time where you have felt, I've made it as a photographer, as a business owner, just in your personal art, you've had that I made it moment? Is there a story you can tell us in that time?
The I made it moment, that's pretty tough. I'm really, really tough on myself, extremely tough on myself. And I really don't ever see myself as an I made it type of person. I see myself more as I can improve on this, or I could be better at this. I bet my clients would really like it if, you know, I did this better. I'm really tough on myself. And that's probably why I do a lot of my networking, because I kind of need somebody to validate that what I'm doing is right. Even at year 11, I don't feel that I have that moment where it's, oh, this is it and I'm doing it right and everything's perfect. I don't know that I'll ever feel that everything's perfect, because like I said, trends in this industry change so much. I never know if I'm doing it right or wrong. For that reason, I have a person that I consult, Skip Cohen, and he helps me through any door that seems to shut. If I feel like a door is shutting, I call him and he works me through it. I think I would have that aha moment. I don't.
Right.
It's a tough industry. It's something hard to work through. And I mean, I love what I do, but I'm very critical of my work and what I do. So it's rough.
Well, and with that path, and especially just, you know, photo world with our service-based industry, I feel like it's not really an I've made it moment, but there are many I've made it moments. And that's the growth of your business. That's the growth of your photography where, yeah, I made it. Now what? You know, and then, oh, now I've made it. Now what? You know, and you just keep repeating it and moving forward and adapting into the new I've made it moment. So it's not so much I've made it. That's the plateau. We're going to settle right here. Because if you do that, then you're going to start failing. So...
You know what? I 100% agree with that. I feel more of it that way. You know, when I was kind of flatlining a little bit, I added the lighting, the quality of light thing came up. And, mm-hmm. you know, and that's when I had that, oh, these pictures are phenomenal. Okay, this is awesome. But after that was done, it was, okay, now what? What can I improve on next? So I have a ton of those little moments all the time. But what it does is it just pushes me beyond that to figure out what I can do next to better myself.
Right. And like you said, that all comes with education. So keep learning, keep growing. Sherry, during your photography career so far, what is the best advice you have ever received?
The best advice I'd ever receive? Just don't ever give up. Keep pushing yourself forward. There's always something new that we can learn from someone. Don't ever, ever think that you're the top notch in this industry. There are some great photographers, and there are some that I consider top notch, but not everybody considers those same photographers on a high standard as I do. No one's perfect, and no one has this down just right. What I do love, something about myself that I consider to be important in my company and the success of my company, is I take critiques from everyone. I take advice from everyone. I have a new employee this year, just came fresh out of college, that has taught me two really cool tricks, because I don't shut my door and I don't think I'm the best at what I do. I don't just flatline my company. I constantly want to learn. And if you have something you can teach me, believe me, I'm going to be the first person that's front and center saying, please show me, show me. So it's always, you have something to learn from someone.
That is awesome. And Photo World, take that with you, because it takes years and years of experience just in life, not even photography, to get to a point where you're open to critiques in what you're doing and learning more on your own. It takes a long time to be okay with that, because we get very protective and very specific about our likes and dislikes, especially with our own work. And that can get a lot of big heads out there, you know? So just realize you're not the only one, and there's still a lot to learn. Like you said, there's a lot of favorites you have. Same here. I have many favorite photographers that others are just like, you know, they're okay. It's like, I don't know how you don't see it. It's perfect. So
it's all about your style. But something else that you had just mentioned about critiques, if you ask somebody for a critique, be prepared to accept their answer. I'm on a lot of photo communities on Facebook, and a lot of people will post a photo looking for constructive criticism. And when somebody gives an honest answer to them, they get really, really mean about the answer. Well, don't ask for it if you don't want it. If you don't want to grow, don't ask for a critique. A critique is to learn how to grow, to get ideas from other people. That's the whole point behind it. Try to open your ears and listen a little bit. Open your mind.
That's a great way to describe how a critique should work. And I'm going to bring that to my classroom, if you don't mind, to share that with my students and just let them know that, you know what, you brought it here for a reason. We're in this class together. Let's learn together. So I love that.
Right. If you don't want it, don't ask for it.
Sherry, if you had to start your photography all over again, you wake up tomorrow, you have the same gear, the same knowledge, your team is still there and your website exists, but the business, it's gone. What would you do first to get that business rolling?
Networking, Rob. Absolutely. Networking is the most important thing in your business you can do. Get to know people. Get to know the big guys. Like I said, in my business right now, I probably abuse a man named Skip Cohen. He helps me work through every aspect of my business. If I have an issue, if I have an advertisement I want him to look over, I email it to him and he'll give me ideas. But I also ask other people in our photography community. Other photographers themselves right here in Chicago, you'll see me post a lot of things on my own Facebook saying, hey, what do you think about this? Or should we tweak this a little bit? Being able to help one another is what takes us further in this industry. Don't lock yourself in a little bubble and just think that everything's going to come to you and it's going to be all right. If you don't put yourself out there and give yourself a chance and learn from others, you're most likely going to sink.
Network, get out there, be a part of the community so the community can be a part of what you're doing. Fantastic. Sherry, do you have a resource like something you use fairly often, Instagram or Facebook maybe, just for your photography and your business that photo world could learn about?
I use Facebook a lot. I use it probably more than I should. but that's a lot of things. If I want to learn new trends, I know a lot of photographers will go to Pinterest or something like that. I don't go to Pinterest. I actually go to the magazine aisle of the grocery store, and I will pick up a high fashion magazine and start looking through it and see what's new out there, what people like. I love the Ralph Lauren stuff. It's really what you set aside as part of your business. You're going to pull your resources from your style. So if your style is more grungy, you might be looking at skateboarding magazines or something like that. Ours is more boutique high fashion. So I pick up a Cosmo or a Vogue magazine and I will look through those. But not only that, my other resources are, like I said, networking. My photographers in Chicago area, business people. I don't just associate myself with photographers. I'm trying to run a business. That's a whole different side of the aspect. Therefore, I'm also running in with the crowd that runs businesses. So I'm asking in both directions. You form a circle. That's all I can say. Form a circle of people.
That's awesome. Yeah. Teams, circles, networking. It all comes down to the same thing. Learn. Get out there and learn from everybody else. There's others who have done it before. So benefit from that by being a part of it, you know, and then you can set the trends. Then you can start the new things. So
right.
That's fantastic. And maybe that overlaps right here. Sherry, can you share with us one parting piece of guidance and then the best way we can reach you?
Yeah, just, you know, keep pushing forward. This isn't an easy industry, and we all want to set ourselves apart, and we want to be different, and we want something new. But in the end of the day, what we all really want is to put a roof over our head. We want to put food on our table, and we want to make sure that we have a nice car to get us from point A to point B. You can do that, but you have to work with other people in order to do that. You've got to associate yourself with the crowd. You've got to network. You've got to be nice with other photographers and learn from them. Don't shut yourself out and don't try to compete. Try to make the industry better by learning new things and bringing new things to this industry. Work together. And you can reach me at my website, www.illusionphotography.com, and that's illusion with an A.
Push forward, work together. And I mean, there's a great book, and I have a written, that's the title on my wall here, Do the Work. Get out there, photo world, and do the work. Hopefully you're listening to this podcast, whether you're on your way to a job or in between or just getting ready in the morning or on a jog, whatever it is. It's great knowledge and education in between that you can take with you, so now you can go do the work. Sherry, thank you so much for being here today. I cannot thank you enough for such great value that you've shared. Photo world thanks you, and happy shooting.
Thanks, Rob. You're doing a really good thing. Keep it up.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Thanks again, Photo World, for being here on the final day of launch week. Tune in next week. We're going to kick it off 3 days a week, starting Monday and continuing Wednesday and Friday. The feedback I have received so far is all the proof I need to say that this is the right thing that the photography community has been waiting for, and that it is my calling to help deliver this information. Please subscribe to Take and Talk Picks on iTunes. If you use Stitcher Radio, subscribe there to Take and Talk Picks. Head over to takeandtalkpicks.com. Subscribe to the newsletter. And in doing so, you're automatically entered for your chance to win an iTunes gift card. Again, we give away one iTunes gift card every single Wednesday. We had a winner this week. We got another one coming up next week. We'll see who it is. Maybe it'll be you. Thank you, Photo World, and happy shooting.